Anyone else? Okay, can someone just tell me what are different kind of the constructor and the different way of the parameter that we can pass in Flutter? As you you know, yesterday, like you mentioned that you learned this thing. So can just someone help me that what exactly kind the different constructor available, or like or different kind of parameter we can, you know, assign or like declare?
Sir, as per my understanding, we have to give the same name as class name, and we can give as many parameters as we have variables in it, and we can make it optional. We can give default values to it, and we can give it named parameters also.
And how we can do it as an optional name parameter and this stuff?
Sir, with the help of curly braces and square brackets.
Okay, so curly braces help us to create which kind of parameter?
Sir, square brackets are kind of default parameters, and curly braces are optional parameters.
Default parameters or compulsory parameters?
I mean, we can assign some default values to it.
So you are saying if I use curly bracket, so I won't be able to assign the default data?
No, if we do not assign some values, it will take the default values that we have given. That's what I...
Yeah. I mean, I just wanted to understand that how much clarity that, you know, everyone have, so that I can start from the... So I just want that, for example, if I am passing some default value to a variable, and that particular variable, I mean the parameter, has been declared as the curly braces. So is it the correct notation or it is not?
Hello, sir.
Hello.
Yep.
Hello, sir.
Yes, ma'am.
Sir, in curly braces, we need to give the value, we can give the value in any order, and in using square bracket, we need to give the same values as we have defined in the constructor.
Okay.
In the same order.
Okay. Okay. And, but still I'm just, you know, waiting for my question's answer. If I give the default value to the parameter and that parameter is wrapped with the curly bracket, is it the correct notation or it will give an error?
Sir, using curly braces, we can say that the parameter is optional. If the user does not pass any value, then we can use the default value also, if we have specified any default value.
Okay. Okay, so let's just get started. Is everyone here or like, should we wait? Ghanshyam sir, or can we start?
Yes, sir, sure.
Perfect. So let's start with the example that we did yesterday. So I'm just sharing my screen. Let me know once it is visible to everyone. Is it visible?
Yes, sir.
Perfect.
Yes.
So I'm just running the code. So yesterday we did two examples. One was simple homepage where we learn about some widgets. And then the another example where we actually created a basic WhatsApp clone. I'm just running that basic WhatsApp clone now. So today what we do is we will create a one simple form where user will be able to interact. We'll pass this data to the next screen and we'll see how we can pass the data from one screen to another screen and how it is visible. Okay. So I guess my simulator is a bit messed up. So I'm just restarting my simulator. We'll rebuild the app. Oh, okay. Hold on. It will open in the Chrome. I need my Pixel. Pixel is here. Perfect. And we will run the app again. Okay. So, and during this learning today, we learn how we will integrate new third-party libraries, how we can use that the third-party libraries, and also a bit of navigation, how we can go back and front, how we can go, you know, one screen to another screen to another screen, how we can come back and how we can, you know, pass the data back and forth. So that we will learn today. So for that, we will create another file. So there is a demo, WhatsApp demo, and now there is a third folder named library third party and underscore navigation. So here we will create a new file called first screen dot dot. Here I will simply create first screen of first stateless widget. I have imported material here. Now we have a screen called first screen. I'll go to main and here I will change from WhatsApp to first screen. I'll import it. Okay. And now we have a blank screen here because on the first screen we don't have anything. So we will quickly write a basic code where scaffold app bar title text. In text we will add first screen. We got that first screen and we will change this green color. I will remove this green color as we don't need it. And when you do this changes in the material app, we required a hot restart rather than the hot reload. This is asking for the const keyword. Okay, we have done this. Now it is also asking for the const. App is here. Body. Now in body, we are going to create one form. Now how that form will look like? So let's just first, you know, draw it somewhere. Let me just help you with draw.io. Okay. So what we'll do is we have here our app bar. We have name here. And we will be having one picture here. Then we will have a kind of text editor. But before that, we have a small label. Like what user is going to insert over here, like here. And the same thing, we will paste it here. And then at the bottom right corner, we will have one small button as a submit. Okay. So we will create this kind of layout. On the center, we will be having one image. For now, we will use the Flutter logo and then we will change it to the image. Then we will have a label called first name. Here user will enter a first name. This label last name. And here again, there is a text field where user can insert last name, and on click on submit, we will show the first name and last name in the toast. Okay, let's see how we can, you know, do this over the in the app. So can someone just guide me, as you have learned yesterday, what widget should I take as a first widget in the body for this kind of
column? Sir, we can take column.
Okay, let's take a column. Then children. Now in children, what we'll do? We'll do Flutter logo first, just to, you know, put as a placeholder. So we have Flutter logo here, but we want a bigger size. So what we'll do, we will add the size equal to 120. Okay, but now this logo is not round. We need a round. So how we can convert this logo into the circle?
Circle avatar.
Circle avatar, but where should I write the circle avatar? I have to wrap this Flutter logo into the circle avatar. Yep. So I'll click on the Flutter logo. I'll click on this bulb icon. There is a one option called wrap with widget. I'll select it and I will replace the widget with the circle avatar. Now, but I can't see it, because I have to give some background color so that, you know, everyone can understand that now we have this round. Now, even though the Flutter logo size is 120, the circle avatar is small. Why it is though? Can someone explain this thing to me?
We need to increase the size of circle avatar.
But don't you think that the circle avatar itself should get, you know, expanded because its child size is 120. Okay, so as you said, let me just remove this and just give the radius here 120. Even though I did that, the child is still small. So now I have to pass the size here as well. Is this the correct way? Do you think this is the correct way?
Can we give size in percentage for logo at
least? No. Here we have to give the absolute size.
Can we use that feet property?
Which property?
Flex fit.
Okay. So where you want me to use it?
Around that logo. Wrap
okay.
it in a flex fit tight.
Okay, so you want me to wrap it with the box fit widget?
Yeah.
Box fit is not a widget.
Okay.
We have the fit. Thank you, sir. We have box fit. So this way, I guess we can do. And what is the other way? If not this, then what is the other way? Because now what I want is, I don't want circle avatar. I want Flutter logo to be 120, but it should be, you know, wrapped with a round. So let's do this way. We can, you know, convert it into the container. So now we have container. We can give it a color, colors.red, for example, but now it's the square. So how we can, you know, change the shape of a container? Anyone have any idea?
Can we apply border?
Sorry?
Border.
Holder?
Border.
Border. In the container, we don't have a border.
Sir, we can use decoration.
Yeah, so we have decoration, box decoration, and here we have a border. And also we have border radius. So you are a bit near. But there is again another thing. If you guys can, you know, just go and just do a quick Google for me. Hello. Can someone do it for me? That how we can do the container as the full circle? There is a one small property over there, if you know. So one thing is common that we need to decorate this. So in the decoration, we have a property called shape. And we can pass the box shape circle. If I do this, it's crashing. Now, why it is crashing? Let's just read the error. So here the error is so much detailed that, you know, you understand why it is, you know, crashing. So here it says that assertion line number 274, POS 15. Now this, till this, it's not, doesn't require. It says that color equal to null or decoration equal to null. Though we either have color equal to null or null decoration equal to null. But we cannot provide both a color and a decoration to provide both. Use decoration. So it is saying that we can't use decoration and color together. So here we are using color and decoration together. That's why it is crashing it. It says don't use together. If you want to give the color, use the box decoration property color. So box decoration have also a property called colors. So we can remove that color property from the container, and from the decoration we can use it. And now we have circle. Is it simple? So as we go inside a Flutter a lot, we come to know that to achieve the similar thing, we can have the different widgets and we can use any widgets to work that way. There is no 100% right way to implement this thing on a particular way. Like one can also implement the way we have done earlier using the circle avatar. Now, I can see some problem here. The borders are going outside of this particular circle. So what we can do is we can actually increase the size of this container a bit more than that. And to do that, we can add the padding or margin to this Flutter logo. So we can add the margin to the Flutter logo, or we can wrap this with the padding widget. Now, if we wrap this with the padding widget and we give padding to every side as the 8. So now it's 8, but now it is still not good. So I'll give it to 16. Now it looks better. Right, but still looks like it is not center. So we can wrap this Flutter logo with the center. Oh, this is something else happened. Let's understand what exactly happened here. Sorry for the street dogs. Hold on. Hello. I hope a disturbance is bit low. Okay. So what exactly we wanted to do and what happened? We actually want to put this logo inside this circle center, but, and also we wanted to put this, the whole picture as the center, but why this center actually, you know, bring the whole widget into the center. So how this happened? Let's just understand this. So column, okay, just to make this, let me just show you how this particular thing is right now working. So I'll wrap it with the container and we'll give a color, colors dot, for example, amber. So we'll understand. So earlier when I was not giving the center, you can see the column is stretched at the size of this particular widget. Whatever, you know, its children is having the size. So it is stretchable with the column. Now column has some property called main axis size. So column's main axis is the X axis, sorry, Y axis. Because column, when you add anything into the column, it will be added on the Y axis from top to bottom. So if I want to limit my column height, what I can do, I can say the main axis size should be minimum. Minimum means whatever the child is there, it should be that only. So this is my column with the yellow background. And if I don't give a size, it by default is a maximum. Now we can go inside the column and we can see what exactly here is. So the minimum X size, main axis size, is by default is main axis size dot max. This is the default value has been already set. And this thing is already into the curly brackets. That's why it is the name parameter. And it is an optional because it is under the curly bracket. So that's why if, even though we don't pass it, it will take the default value as the maximum and will stretch it down. Now, when we put the center inside the column, it understands. Okay, first let me just remove this container as well. And just let's just keep this here and let's wrap padding with the center. So this center widget will actually ask if parent widget here in the case is the container, sorry, column. And it says that, hey, whatever your size is, the maximum size, just give it to me. And then I will place myself in the center of that particular size. So if we go back to the previous state, which is like this, and if I again put the center and wrapping around the Flutter logo only, so here what will happen? So the center is asking a padding that, hey, give me the size of height and width so that I can place myself on the center. Now padding says that, hey, I don't have the fixed size. I'll ask my parent widget. So now padding is asking to the container, and now container also doesn't have the fixed size. So it is asking to the column. Now column says I have the maximum size as a width is this and height is this, but I have the constraint in terms of the height. So you will be placed on the top of the column, but horizontally you can be placed at the center. And that's why when you define a center here, it is actually getting applied to the whole columns. And that's why it is in the center. So this is a very tricky layouting stuff. If you don't understand this, you might end up, you know, by doing something else, and whatever you are expecting, it won't be there on the screen. So just make sure that, you know, whatever you are doing, it is there. And if we want to just put this logo into the center, like for example, we can do container width equal to 400. Sorry, it size box. Now width equal to 400 and height equal to 100. So, and let me wrap it with the container and give it a color, colors dot red. Size box is still not working because its parent is not allowing me. So here we can use the fitted box. Fitted box will also won't work here. Yes, because here the size constraints are there. What I can do here is, hold on. So this is our default behavior. And I want to make it as a center. So I will make the whole container as a center first. So this is in the center. Now here I can give width to the 100. Yes. So it will always go for the parent and it will ask that, hey, what is the size? And if I want to constrain, I can constrain by that way only. And that's the issue. So sometimes I also get, you know, like confused why it is not working. So now we will remove this amber, and now we know that this is actually the whole column. So we have the column. Now we need one list label here. So below the center, we will add a text. And here we'll say first name. Now we got the first name here. But what we want is we want to give some style, text style, where the font size is a bit 18. Okay. And now we will have text filled. Now we have a text field where, you know, user can type anything, but this text field doesn't look good. And also this first name is here. According to design, we need over here somewhere. So how we can do this? So actually in a column, we have another property called cross axis. So for the column, the cross axis is the X axis. And here we can say that, hey, what is the cross axis alignment? So cross axis alignment we need from the start. So we need everything, whatever we are placing inside, should be from the left hand side. So as I do, it comes on the left hand side. Now, if you are saying this, the logo is still on the center because we have wrapped this container into the center. If I remove this center widget, save it, it again comes to the left hand side. So in such case, now it has a constraint. So now it will work appropriately. Now column is actually giving its children's constraint that, hey, you have to be start from the left and from the top. And when a new widget will be added, it will be below the earlier widget. So we have added the one widget. Now by default, it was on the left. We tell them, hey, we want the center. So we wrap it with the center. Now center is asking the column, hey, now I want to go to center. Just give me your width. So it will get stretched to the fullest. And then we got the width, then it plays itself on the center. The text is still again, you know, following the constraint given by the column. And that's why it is on the left align. So that's why this first name and this is here. Now we want to duplicate the same thing for the last name. So I'll simply copy. I'll simply paste here and I'll change first name to last name. Now we want some spacing in between. So we have size box. I will add here the height. Height is equal to, for example, 40. Now everyone required the const keyword. Const here, const, maybe here also const and const. Okay, so now we have something here. Now we need a button on the right hand side in the bottom, right? So how we can go? So let's just first add the button here. So we have elevated button. Elevated means a bit elevated, which, you know, user can feel. And on the child, we can pass anything, like any widget we can pass. Here we will pass simple text because we want a text which is named as a submit. So now we have the button called submit here. And if I press it, you can see there is some effect. Now I want this button on the right hand side. How I can do this? Any idea? Can someone help me with this?
Sorry? And then using, we can wrap the button in a row widget.
Okay, let's just do it in the row. Okay.
And we can use and.
Main axis alignment and this is what you are suggesting?
Yes.
Awesome. It is done. Perfect. Thank you. But what if I don't want to use the row? Because row actually used to, you know, have multiple widgets inside it. Do we have any other option? Like, does anyone aware about this? Any other option can think of? No? Okay, let me just help you. So there is another widget called alignment. Let's just try that out. So I'm wrapping it with the widget. And we have align. And it has alignment. Alignment dot right. Or like center right. and it is on the right hand side. If I put as the center left, it comes on the center left. If I put as the center, we have the center. If I go to the bottom right, you can see it's not going bottom because it has the constraint, the align, that whatever the is child height is, it will be have only that much of height. So now what if I want to put this button at the below of the screen, of the total screen? How I can do this? Yesterday, have you learned the widget called expanded? Expanded. So what this expanded widget do? When you place a expanded widget, whatever the size that the remaining size, it take all the remaining size. If I click over here, you can see now the keyboard is coming up. So the remaining size is this much of only. So it is actually taking this much size and putting my widget according to the align widget on the bottom right. Now, if I put here this alignment, you know, and I will change it to like center right. You can see is the center right. Top right. Center, top center. And bottom center. And if I want to put as center as possible, this is as center. If I click on it, keyboard will pop, come up. And you know, we have the button at the center. Till now, is it clear? The alignment specifically, because this alignments are a bit tricky. If you do not understand how exactly a particular widgets work, you might ended up, you know, by writing unnecessary widgets wrapper. Like, you know, you might wrap it with the alignment and then again expand that, then again with the row and column and container, which is like unnecessary. Even though the Flutter won't complain that even though, you know, you will wrap it with more number of widgets, but ideally you should avoid it as maximum numbers of the widgets. Try to utilize as minimum because Flutter has so many widgets. So this is a kind of the another way that we can do it. Now, according to design, we want to put it on the bottom right. So we have put at bottom right, but again, it is, you know, like connected to the screen. Also, this everything is connected to the screen. What I want is I want something like this. I mean, the button should be a bit up like here. And, you know, we need some kind of padding around it. So if I want to give padding to the overall screen, where I should be giving it? It's better to give padding to the column. So I'll wrap it with the padding. Here I have the property of all, where I can give the padding to at the every size, which is 8. I have the another option called only, where I can define. For example, I want to give left padding as in 16, right padding as in 16, and bottom padding as the 8. And I don't want to give any padding on the top. As you can see, we have some padding left and right and bottom. Now, if I want to give, you know, this kind of padding, bottom, top, and 8. So now you can see the top and bottom has similar padding. Left and right has a similar padding. So we have the another constructor rather than only. We have a symmetric constructor where it has the parameter like horizontal padding. So in horizontal, I will add 16. In vertical, I will write 8. So it will do the same thing. And if you are like kind of a bit lazy like me, and if you don't like this top, left, right, and you want to give the different padding, we have the fourth constructor, which is from LTRB, which is like left, top, right, bottom. So like from left, we have 16, top, we have 10, bottom, right, we have again 12, and bottom, we have 25. So you can see we have the different padding in the all the four direction. So you can use any of it, depends on your requirement and depends on your usability and your simplicity. For now, we will use the symmetric because I want to give horizontal padding 16 and vertical as an 8. Okay, now this looks a bit better, but again, this, I mean, there should be a hint, like, you know, over here that what exactly user is going to type. So how we can do this? So in the text field, we have something called decoration, maybe. And here we have input decoration. In input decoration, we have hint text. Here we can write your name. And also, we can actually remove this label. For example, I am just removing this label, and we have the floating label. So here in the input decoration, we have the another property called label. First name. Here you can see, if I start writing it, and if I come over here, it will become as in the hint text. As soon as I click on it, it becomes the label. And you know, we have the this one call as a hint text. We can use both the way based on your design and everything. And also we can you know, do the last name as the same style, but it won't have this kind of animation. So this actually looks better. So we will remove this label and we will use almost similar kind of decoration for our this text field. And your write your name, last name here. And here we'll say write your first name. Why is it didn't came? Happened. Oh, it is already here. We have to remove this label. Now it looks a bit better. Now what we want to do is, on click of this submit button, we want to show the toast. Now showing a toast required a third party library, because there is no direct plugin available, because toast is different in Android and is different in iOS. So to show the toast, we need third-party library. But before that, let's just, you know, get this data. Like first name, I will write Drumal. And on the last name, I will write Shah. And as soon as I click on it, I should at least get a Drumal Shah, at least in my console, like somewhere here. So that, you know, then we can place it inside the our like toast. So for this, I at least want to bind something to this text editor. And for that, we have to take text controller, text editing controller, first name. And I am creating it. And then we have the last name. Last name. Now, if you see, it is actually throwing me error. It is saying that you can't define a constructor as a const because you have something which is non-constant. And now this is also throwing me error that it is not used. So what we'll do is we'll simply pass this controller to our text field. So in text field, we have one parameter called decoration. Now we will add another parameter called controller. We will pass first controller over here, first name controller. Why it is throwing an error? And here we have last name controller. It says invalid constant value. Why this is invalid? Because here we have applied the const, because now this is not a constant, it is runtime. So we have to remove this const variable here. And also we have to remove this const here, but again it is throwing error because this input decoration in the const. So we'll pass the const here. Const. Now it should work. Now it is working. Now, but still we don't have the data here. What we can do is, on click on that, we can actually use this first name controller and last name controller, and it has the property called text. So here we'll take a string first name equal to first name controller dot text and string last name equal to last name controller dot text. And what we'll do, we'll simply print is like debug print. Here we'll simply write our first name equal to dollar first name and our last name is last name. We'll run this and let's see. Are we getting it now? Because we have to restart it. So here it's seeing some error here on the first screen. What is that? It says try using a constructor or factory that is const. Now it is throwing an error because it requires a constant, and now we don't have, because we have something called text controller over here. So if I pass over here const, it's throwing me error. If I'm doing this, it's again throwing me error. The reason is because we are changing the state of it. So we have to wrap this first screen or create is as a stateful widget, not the stateless. So what we'll do is we'll simply click on it. We have a bulb and it says that convert to stateful. We'll simply press on it. It will get converted to the stateful. And is it still causing an error? This is weird. Okay. Now it is here. Perfect. Because it requires a like constant constructor. So we have created it. We have converted it into the stateful widget. And now if I pass it here, like Drupal SHA, and if I press on submit, we can see our first name is Drupal and last name is SHA. If I change it here and click on submit, it'll say Drew and SHA. Okay. Till now, anyone have any doubt in layouting stuff, why we have converted this stateless to the stateful? Any doubt till now? No?
No, sir.
Okay. Now, it is also, you know, suggesting me one thing, that hey, private field could be final. Because now, as we are applying a constructor here, we are already assigning one object. We can actually declare it as the final. And that's the reason that, you know, here we are using the final and here we are using the const. If I again hot restart it, and I'll write anything here, we can see the first name, last name here. All right. Now let's just go to the pub.dev. And here, okay. So pub.dev, enter. Now we need a toast. So this is the official website where all the plugins and third-party libraries are available. You can simply go here and search whatever you want. They have some Flutter favorite, like which are like using like very regularly. You can see these most popular packages here, which has been used. Some top Flutter packages as well. Some Dart packages as well. So here we need a package called Toast. So we have like multiple Toast, Flutter Toast, OK Toast, Flutter Style Toast, Motion Toast. So which one we should be using? So always check for this kind of, you know, the nomenclature, which is like verified. Also right hand side, they are giving, you know, some numbers which says that this package, how many lines this package has, likes in terms of the GitHub likes. If you go here, you can see it has a GitHub repository on our right hand side. And on the GitHub, it has this one, 1.1k stars. These stars actually define dislikes. The pub points are the points that, you know, this particular pub.dev gives, which is like it follows the file convention, provide documentation, support multiple platform, support up-to-date dependency, sound null safety and everything. So if it is like, you know, 130 out of 130, you should do this, and popularity, obviously. So this way you can decide which plugin one should be using. Now, as we decided that, you know, we will go with this plugin, this Flutter Toast. So I'll click on it, Flutter Toast. I'll go here and there is a button called copy. I'll simply click on it. It says that copy to clipboard. I'll come back here and we will insert into the pub spec. Now, as yesterday we discussed, to integrate any library, we have to go to the pubspec.yml. We'll go to the dependency and here we'll add enter one indentation back just below the Flutter. We'll simply put this Flutter Toast 8.0.8. And as soon as I'll press command S, it will automatically run the Flutter pubget command for me. And if it doesn't run for you, you can go to terminal and type Flutter pubget. As soon as it is done, you can see on the output the exit 0. Let's see. So now we got the exit code 0, which is like it has been downloaded successfully. And now we can use it. Now, how to use it? So for that, there is a documentation. So it says how to use. Go to Flutter Toast. Add this line to your dependency. We have done this. Import this file. We will import it later. And then it says just use this code. So we'll simply copy this. We'll go into our code where we want to put, which is into the button on press event on the below line. We will do here and we'll simply do command V. As you can see, it's throwing me error because we haven't imported. Click on it, import, and this is done. So what it says, so how many parameters it has? Let's just first check it. It says Flutter Toast dot show toast message. This is a center short toast. But what message we want to show here is, we'll show a message like entered name is first name space last name. The toast length is length short. Now what is length short? If you have worked on Android, you know the short length is equal to 2 to 3 seconds and long length is equal to 5 to 6 seconds. Now toast gravity is the center. Time in second for iOS web, we don't require this. Background color red, we don't want it. Text color white, we don't want it. Font size, we don't want it. Because it must be having some default value. So we are removing all this thing. We just want to pass the message and let's see what happens. So I'll simply press on save. It doesn't work. The reason is, as we have installed the new dependency, so this dependency actually been inserted into Android and iOS both. So when you install new dependency, you have to restart the app. You have to stop the app, go into your app and build again. Otherwise it won't work for you. So always keep this in mind. Whenever you install any new dependency, try this. So let's just wait once it will be done. And then we can see our toast. Okay, now we have ready. Now I can write here like government here I'll write Polytechnic. Please on submit. You can see entered name is Government Polytechnic. I mean, the spelling is wrong, but we can see this, the toast here, right? Now, if we don't want to toast, there is one default thing, which is a snake bar. So we can also show the snake bar. For that, we have scaffold messenger dot off context dot show snake bar. And on snake bar, we have a ready-made widget called snake bar. And in content, we can pass any widget, right? So here we will simply pass text. And in text, we will simply copy this text. Now we'll save it and we'll simply submit. You can see the snake bar below in. Okay, let me just comment this, the Flutter toast. Now you can see entered name is Government Polytechnic. So this is the snake bar, which is like very common. So you can, if you are not willing to show the toast, like any third-party library, we have the default called snake bar, the snake bar widget. And to call this snake bar widget, we have a method called scaffold messenger of context dot snow snake bar. Now, just please pay attention. This is a very important thing. This particular notation, scaffold messenger dot off context. This is a third type of widget, which is known as the inherited widget. So here, what we are looking for to display on the screen, we want to show the snake bar. Now, to show the snake bar, we at least need a context that, hey, I want to show the snake bar, but where I want to show the snake bar? I want to show the snake bar on the current screen. Now, how I can get the reference of the current screen? Where I can get the reference of the current screen? So, to get the reference of the current screen, I need a context. So, context, I can get it from here, build method. This one. But this is only this screen. I want the whole screen, my first screen context. So I'm telling him that, hey, scaffold messenger, I need the context of this. So this context, which I'm getting of the screen, I need the whole screen. So this will actually, you know, check for this context and get the whole screen object. And then from that object, it will show the snake bar. So whenever you find this kind of thing, it means it actually look for its parents widget, because here, if we see the parent widget of this elevated button is align extended, but we need a widget which has the context and which has the first screen. So we need a first screen context. And to get this, we are using this notation of context. Okay. Any doubt till now? Are everyone with me as of now?
Yes, sir.
Perfect. Now what we want to do is we want to put one image here, which we fetch from the internet. So for that, we'll go to internet. We'll search for a dummy image. Maybe we'll look for my image only. Let's see. Let's go to my profile. How I can go to profile? Okay, profile. I'll open. Okay. Open image in new tab. And I got this URL. Now I want to show this image over here. So for that, we need to change this implementation from Flutter logo and container, everything. So we will remove this. For now, I'll just simply put in comment. I'll save it. So it is gone. We have a thing called image.network. You might have learned yesterday image.asset. Yesterday you learned this image.assets, where you are getting the path from the assets.
Yes, sir.
Yes. Okay. Yes. Now that images are the static images which you put inside the asset folder. But now what if, because most of the time we are getting the image as a URL from the server, and then we need to show that image. So here what we are going to do is we are going the same thing, image.network, and we are passing the URL, and it should show on the screen. We can see the image over here, but our requirement is something like this. We want image in the circle. So what should we do? Should we put it into the container at the decoration or like the circle avatar? What should be your call? What is your suggestion? Hello?
Circle avatar, sir.
Circle avatar? Let's do it. So wrap with widget. Where is it? Okay, so wrap with widget. And here we'll do circle avatar. Save it. It's still like circle or not a circle. Let me just add the size, which is radius 120. It's still not circle. Why? Let me just give the background color as well so that you know we can see what exactly the circle avatar's border. Even we can't see the circle avatar's border as well. What if I remove the child for now? Okay, so it is actually covering the whole part. For example, if I give the padding something here, padding 20, like we can see that it is actually covering end to end square. It's not getting cut. What we want is we want images getting cut over here. So what is the best way to do this? Any other suggestion? So circle avatar is not working.
Sir, can we use fit property?
Fit property of image?
Yes, sir.
But image view is already this, and so image is already fitting into the image view. What we want to do is we want to put this image view to we get fit into the circle avatar or like in the circle. So the fit property won't work here. Fit property actually work for image view and image. We want image view to get fit into this circle avatar. So fit property is not the solution for this. So there are two alternate solutions. Let's just try with the first one. What we can do is we can tell circle avatar, hey, rather than on the child property, we want to set your background image. So it has a background image. So we will do image provider dot network. Do we have that? Image dot network provider. We have another widget called network image provider. Network image. So what it returns? Yes, it returns image. So here we can pass a URL. And here we can see on the background the image is set, and also in the child it has been set. So now I will remove this child parameter of the circle avatar. And here we can see we have an image. Okay. And we can like wrap it with the center. So it's the center here. Center and const. So this is the first way how we can do, like we can use the circle avatar and on the background image, we can put the image. So what will happen? The other part of the image will get crop off and it will be marked inside this particular thing. Now, as you have, paid attention, I'm not using image.network. I'm using network image. The reason is the child was expecting a widget. So image.network returns widget. This returns widget. Now this network image actually returns network image. A network image is the image provider. It extends the image provider. So, and this background image parameter look for image provider. So that's why the image.network won't work here. We need someone who returns the image provider, not the image widget. Now, I am not convinced with the way. I still want image.network only to do my stuff. So I'll simply copy this code and we will implement with the another way. image dot network, right? And now we have another thing called container, but here container we have clip or rectangle. Now what this clip or rectangle do? Can you guess what it will do based on the name?
Clip the image.
Okay, clip the image. What else?
If we provide radius, then we can clip it in circle also.
Correct. So clip our React have the border radius. And here we can provide some radius. So here we can provide border radius dot circular. And here like 20. So it will get clipped like 20, 20. And if I want 360, it becomes circle. Now what I do is I can reduce the size. So we don't have width and height. So now how I can reduce the size of it? So what we can do, we can go here into the image. I can provide width is equal to 120, height, height is equal to 120, and this become the 120. And now we can wrap it with the center. We have the center. So now we have like multiple ways, like this is the first and this is the another way that we used, right? Let me just reduce the size. Okay. And both are doing the similar thing. Here we use image.network, clip art, react and center. Here we use network image, circle avatar and center. And both are the correct way. There is no incorrect way of implementing it. Okay. Now, what will happen if I have multiple images like this? So let's do one thing. Clicking on it, let's redirect to the second screen. So we'll create a new screen, which is second screen dot dot. Here I'll create stateless widget, second screen. Simply import scaffold f bar title text second screen and const. Okay, we got the another screen. Now clicking on it, I want to redirect to the next screen. So to redirect to the next screen, what we need is we need someone who can navigate me from one screen to another screen. So that particular navigator should know that where I am right now and where I want to go. So actually the Flutter is written in such a way that the way we are say it has that kind of widgets and the classes. So as we say, it's a navigator. So we have the navigator. Now we want to push the new screen. So we have the push. So now from where we want to go, let me just write it down for you. Otherwise, you know, this automatic will give me a lot of thing. So we have navigator dot push. Now push have two things. One is from where you want to go, I mean, what is your current context? And second, where you want to go is the route. Now, for the route, we have material page route widget. And in material page route, there is a builder because it is actually building that widget. So if we say in the builder, it has the context because from the one context, it is creating the another. So here we are returning my second widget, which is the second screen. And I'll pass const. So what will happen as soon as I press on it, it will be show something over here and it will be redirect to the next screen. See, on the next screen, I am here. Okay. Have we written the code of this, the back button till now? हमने इसका कोड लिखा है? Did we write the code for this back button?
No, sir.
No? See, the Flutter is quite smart enough that it knows that this is the second screen and we require this back button. It is already, you know, implementing it. It's good, right? And what if we don't want this back button? So we can tell Ebbar, hey, automatically imply leading is should be false. But don't imply anything automatically until I say. So it will be hidden. Like this. Okay. So now it is not here. Now you can see one problem here. As soon as I click on it, my button got shrink. Right? And we don't want to do this. Do you like this kind of behavior? Button, like, you know, getting shrink, is it doesn't look good, right? So what we can do, we can go here and we have used expanded. Now we don't want to use expanded. What we'll do, we'll simply remove this. So it is here, but now I want to put this at the end of it. So we have a one widget called spacer. What spacer will do, spacer will add a space till it has. So it do the same thing over here. And as soon as I click on it, now it is creating a problem because now it is actually overlapping on each other. So now this is the new problem and the button is still coming up. I don't want button to come up. It's okay if it has been covered by the keyboard because user will press the back button to hide the keyboard and then click on submit, right? So what we can do here, so we want to tell the screen, hey, don't override this thing. So for that, in the scaffold we have a property call resize to avoid bottom inset equal to true. Now what does it does, sorry, my bad, false. So by default it's true. So we are saying that hey, don't resize the screen. You know, when any keyboard comes, the screen shouldn't get resized. Earlier it was getting resized, but now we are saying don't do this. And if we don't want to do this, we can also have the another solution that will, you know, come later part. So this looks a bit good now. Now what we want to do is, as soon as we click on it, it should get redirected to the second screen. And we don't want to show this scaffold or anything over here. We want to actually pass this data to the second screen. And over here in the text, we want to show that data. So first, let's just create the second screen. And let's just put here some body. We'll create the design first. So here again, we'll put the column the children. And then we'll put text, selected first name equal to, for example, right now I'm just putting as a static Drupal. And here selected last name is equal to Shah. Now I want as a center, I can put everything on the center is like this way, like cross axis alignment center. So everything will come in the center. No, it won't coming. Reason. What's the reason why it is not coming on the center? Let's see.
Sir, we need the main axis alignment for column. Because that is why.
This is the reason. My column width is only just this much only. So it is already centered. See, you can see that second text is already centered. But I want the whole thing as a center. So as you said, we need to put the column as a center. So let's just do this and it is centered. Perfect. Now what we want to do is I want to replace this name with the variable, whatever the data that I'm getting from the top. So right now, let me just define final first name here is equal to like static Drupal and final last name is equal to static Shah. And I'll simply write here dollar first name, dollar last name. Now here two things that you need to keep in mind, or like you can pay attention, is like, even though I am using the double quote or single quote, it is not making any difference here. You can see here, like in the Drupal, I have wrapped with a double quote, and here Sha, I have wrapped with a single quote. Even though I wrap a particular data with a double quote or single quote, it will treat as a string only. So there is no difference between that. So that's the good part. Also, I'm not defining any data type here. It is just the final keyword and just the variable name. By default, any variable you declare, the data type of it is the dynamic. So as soon as you give a data to this particular object or a variable, it will automatically implicitly inherit or like become of that particular data type, the kind of data that it will receive. If I pass like 10 here, it becomes the integer. The string is not of integer function result. Hold on. So we can see here the 10 is here with the integer. So it's just simply like that only. So whatever data that I will pass, it will simple work like this. Like for example, if I pass 6.9, I need to restart it. And see 8.9. So this is the way that, you know, if you don't know what kind of data that you are receiving, you can do this. Now, what I want to do is I want to pass the data from the earlier screen to this screen. So this is actually a class, and from here I'm calling a class. So what I can do, I can just simply create a constructor. So constructor is already there with the optional parameter called key. Now I will add two more parameter, which is like first name and last name. The best part of the Flutter is you can directly write this dot first name, this dot last name. And here I can define a parameter, because now I'm getting the data from the outside. So I got it. Now it says the parameter first name can't have a value of null because of its type, but the implicit default value is null. In the Dart, the latest Dart version, which is 2.8, I guess, or maybe 2.3. Hold on, let me just verify what is the latest Dart version. Latest Dart version. So it's 2.12. So this is the latest version. So once this Dart 2 has came, it comes with the null safety. So null safety, it means most of the time in the development, we are facing the problem of null pointer exception. Just to get rid of this null pointer exception, most of the new high level languages providing this null safety, including Kotlin, everyone. So Dart is also, you know, providing that. So what it says that this particular variable name, this particular variable will not contain any null value. If it contains any null value, just tell them that, hey, it can have null. So as we know that it might have null value, we can just say that, hey, this string can have null. Okay. So any variable name which data type is postfix with the question mark, then this variable can have the null value. And if we want this, that it shouldn't be containing null value, what we can say, we can tell them, hey, whenever you call this method, we required this data. So that's why it won't have null value. We have to have passed this data. So as we prefix with the required keyword, you can see it is throwing me error over here that, hey, it says we have to implement these two parameters, first name, last name. Now, in first name, last name, what we can pass? We can pass this variable name. So here I can pass my variable name, which is the first name, last name. Now it is a bit ambiguity here, so I will just convert it to like with underscore. And there is a difference here. No, this is not actually the problem. The problem is this const, because now it is not constant. Now sometimes you feel that what is this first name and what is this first name. So you can just change it, the variable name, to fn and ln, or you can do it with the underscore. Does anyone know what is the difference between a variable name with underscore or without underscore? There is a very huge difference.
Sir, maybe underscore is used to indicate it's a private property.
Correct. Or private variable. Correct, exactly. So in the Dart, when you want to define any variable and which is private, you need to define it with the underscore. So now we are passing the data from this screen to this screen using this constructor. In this class, we are fetching this data. Now this dot first name actually works like the way we used to write a constructor like this. For example, if I'm writing the constructor string first name, and this dot first name equal to first name. So rather than writing the whole line, Dart is smart enough that he knows that, okay, if you are doing this dot first name, whatever the data that you are getting over here, it is getting passed here. So it is actually removing this. And that's why the notation, the whole long notation, will just convert it to this dot first name like this. So Dart has done some of the smart thing for the developers, like, so that you can actually, you know, see the code which is more beautiful and readable and more easy to understand. Let's just see whether this code works or not. So here I'll write Manisha, and here I'll write Mehta. I click on enter and we'll click on submit. I can see the selected first name is Manisha and selected last name is Mehta. So we are able to successfully pass the data from first screen to another screen. Now I want to actually pass one number which actually generate the image that the image I am passing for that number of time. So here I'll again introduce one new variable, integer counter, counter counter. Here again I will say required this dot counter, and here again I will say final string image URL. Required this dot image URL. Okay, here will, for now, counter I am just pasting 10 and statically, and for image URL we are using the same image URL of my image. Now I want this image. Hold on. Okay. Now I want this image 10 times. I mean, whatever the time that I write here into the list view, but only this part of the screen, not the whole thing should get scrolled. Not this first name and last name. Let me just first give some styles to this first name and last name, like style, text style, text style. Font size is equal to 20. Perfect. And font weight dot bold. Okay. So we have this. We'll simply copy this style and we'll paste it here. Now we have this. We'll add some spacing here, which is the size box with the height 10. And we'll put another size box here with the size of 30. Now we want a list view. Yesterday we learned how we can, you know, generate a particular list. So we will do list view dot builder. Here in the item builder, we want a image. So we'll simply use this notation. We will return image dot network and whatever the URL that we are getting. Here we are getting from image URL. We are already getting image URL. I simply use this. Okay, hold on. I guess I need to restart it. There's some issue with my debugger. Now we are passing this image URL and it should get, you know, like work so gracefully because we haven't passed the item count. Let me just first see this, how it will work, and then we'll pass the item count. Okay, it's throwing an error because the unbound height, widget, and everything. So here's some problem we got it. The list view is asking for a size. Now list view is a part of the column. Now column has unlimited size, I mean the whole screen, right? Let me just show you what exactly I'm saying. Let me just comment it out. And so container colors dot amber, and we'll go here. Okay, we'll go here. So now we have, you know, this kind of stuff. Now list view also take the full height. Now list view needs some constraint that, hey, where should I end? Because it requires the scroll. So it requires some fixed height so that it can tell that, hey, this is my fixed height, like 300 pixel, 400 pixel. And I can put children inside that and then the scroll behavior will happen. Now column doesn't have that the fixed size in terms of the height because it just, you know, go on and on till the screen has, and it doesn't have that kind of the static number. So now this is a problem. How we can solve it? So the widget that we use, which is the expanded widget, that will actually give us some constraint. So we will wrap it with the expanded. Expanded will tell, hey, column, whatever the size you have, just give it to me. So now expanded has some constraint that, hey, I have the X number of height. This height will be enforced to the list view. List view will take this and will render itself. Now you can see we have, you know, unlimited images. What we can do, we can give item count as in the counter. Now as we have only 10, we can see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Simple, but it also doesn't look good. So what we'll do, we'll simply add some padding just to get some idea. So now we have this padding inside and we have 10 images. Now this image is a bit small. Let me just go and, you know, add some heavy images and I'll show you what exactly I'm trying to. Some high resolution images will get it, which almost have, you know, the a big size, almost 20-25 MB. This is 54 MB, 25 MB. Okay, so this is almost 25 MB size. Let's see what happens if we pass this image over here for the 10 image. So as you can see, we have 25 MB of image, and if we are rendering the 10 images, so almost it requires 25 × 10, 250 MB of memory. So if we do such heavy lifting, what will happen? It's not loading at all. It's taking too much time to get load. It's a 25 MB image. So ideally, what should happen here? We need a kind of a loader somewhere. Now it is just a 10. What if I convert it to the 100? Is it 100 or it has not been done yet? I don't think so. It has been implemented. Okay. Because I need to do it like this way. Like, see, this is the 100 images. 100 times. So, if such kind of thing happens, and if we do like, you know, this back and forth, in iOS, it will get crashed because iOS memory management is very strict. If we are taking more memory, you know, in terms of images, it will just crash the image, crash the app. So to manage this, we have another plugin, and which is like very well-known plugin called Cache Network Image, pub.dev cached network image. This one. So what it will do, it will actually cache for that particular image. And whenever this kind of URL come, it will fetch from the cache. It will not actually call the your network. So what we can do is here, we can simply go to pubspec.yml, again enter another dependency, which is 3.2.0 cache network image. We'll stop the app once it has been downloaded. Yes, we got output as in the zero. Okay, and now we will do here return cache network image, and here we have image URL, and we will simply remove this. So it is taking a bit time of building the app. And it's here. So the first image will take time to get downloaded it. Once it is, so it is downloaded. Now we can see a kind of smooth scrolling of 100 image. There is no lag at all. And we can add some padding. Smooth scrolling. If I go back and come again, you can see the image is getting loaded as soon as possible because now it is coming from the cache. Even though now if I like, you know, switch off the internet, go back, come again, the image is still loaded. So that's the benefit of using the cache network images. And that's why you should use it. Also, the cache network image has some other parameters. For example, if the image is not proper, we have the error widget. If URL is not working, so it shows some other widget over there. If we want to put some loader over there, we can show the placeholder as well. So we have placeholder image, placeholder widget. So you can try and, you know, explore this thing. So the today's goal was to, you know, help you understand how we can pass the data from one screen to another screen, how we can use the third-party libraries that we use to Toast and the network image. That way you can utilize it and do it. So that's it for the day for this first session, and then we'll come again meet at the third session. Let me know if you have any questions. Hello.
No questions.
Okay. Any doubt or anything? Perfect. Keep it ready for and we will cover it up over there. Hello?
Yes, sir. We may end the session now.
Okay.
Thank you very much, sir, for the beautiful session. Dear participants, we will start our second session of day 3, sharp at 12:30 p.m. Thank you very much, sir, once again.
Thank you, everyone. Bye.